This is Kurt Heisinger, accounting professor at Sierra College and author of Managerial Accounting. This video describes how to use a measure called economic value added to evaluate an investment center. Investment centers are those responsibility centers where managers are responsible not only for profits, for costs, but also for investments in long-term assets. And economic value added is a measure very similar to residual income in evaluating these types of investment centers. But there are some differences as well. So we're going to talk about the similarities and differences as we go through this video and also talk about how to calculate the economic value added measure. So EVA was developed to provide financial information without what some would call the anomalies that result from following GAAP, meaning that there are some areas, some requirements that GAAP imposes on companies that don't necessarily apply to a measure like economic value added. So economic value added then provides an opportunity for companies to make some adjustments. So when using the economic value added, or EVA, organizations do make adjustments to operating income and to average operating assets. I've created a separate video talking about how to calculate residual income, how to calculate this measure. You should probably take a look at that first before looking at economic value added and the calculation you're going to see here, because the residual income video describes how to do that, and there's just some slight differences between that and economic value added. But back down to the last bullet point here, when using economic value added, organizations then make adjustments to operating income, and operating income is used for the residual income calculation, and adjustments to the average operating assets, which is also used in the residual income calculation. However, most firms do limit adjustments to, studies have shown this, limit the number of adjustments that they make to 15 or fewer, and in fact, it tends to be much lower than that in terms of the adjustments that are made. Some of the more common adjustments that are made to operating income and average operating assets are shown here in this slide. So these are the common adjustments. There are three here. There are many more, but these are the three most common. The first that you see here has to do with research and development. And GAAP requires companies to basically expense research and development costs as they are incurred. And therefore, those expenses are in the income statement during that one period when they are incurred, and that's it. However, many companies feel that research and development costs will benefit the company in future periods. So, for example, if we're a pharmaceutical company and we're spending a lot of money on research and development, those research and development costs may benefit us in the future if we, in turn, have a viable product from those costs that we are able to sell for future years. As a result, EVA, economic value added, one of the adjustments to it, allows us to capitalize or record as assets those research and development costs, and then amortize those costs over the estimated useful life of those research and development activities. Very similar to how the purchase of a piece of equipment can be capitalized and then depreciated over the useful life of that asset. Another adjustment that's often made has to do with advertising, the second item here. And again, GAAP requires that all advertising costs be expensed as incurred. But many companies feel that advertising costs and promotional materials benefit those companies for future periods, and therefore EVA allows for the capitalization of these costs, again recording these costs as an asset and then amortizing them over a period of time. And the third adjustment that's typically made has to do with non-interest bearing current liabilities, and EVA says we can deduct these non-interest bearing current liabilities from our average operating assets, and therefore we come up with a new and lower average operating asset amount. Here's a summary of the equation related to economic value added, and it looks much like calculating residual income. So what we do is we take the net operating profit after taxes, but we make adjustments to those. We just talked about a couple of those possible adjustments. We make adjustments. It's not necessarily in accordance with GAAP, is what we're saying here. We make adjustments, and that is dependent on the company. The company has to decide what types of adjustments to make to that operating profit. So we take net operating profit after taxes, adjusted, and we subtract from that the percent cost of capital times average operating assets, which is exactly the same as what we do for residual income. However, we can make adjustments to the average operating assets, and we also discussed that on the previous slide. And what's left over then is the economic value added dollar amount. All right, so here's an example. There's a lot of information on this slide, but we've been using Game Products Inc. for all of the different measures being discussed when evaluating an investment center. And so we use this same exact company and the same exact information in talking about calculating return on investment and talking about calculating residual income and even in terms of calculating the gross profit margin ratio. And you'll see that information here. We'll see that this is Game Products, Inc. All these dollar amounts are in thousands. And this is information, by the way, for the year ended December 31. And you'll see we have three different divisions. The Sporting Goods Division, these are all investment centers. Each of these, I should say, is an investment center. The Board Games Division and the Computer Games Division. What you see here then is kind of a roadmap. The information that these arrows point to is used to figure out residual income and to calculate return on investment. And as I said, we've done that in two separate lectures using this same exact information. Now what we're going to do is focus on the adjustments that we'd make to the information used for residual income and return on investment so that we can then calculate economic value added. And so the starting point is the operating income here. Let me change the color a little bit. This right here, the operating income. And with average operating assets here, and we're gonna start with that. And those are the numbers that were used for residual income and return on investment. And we're going to make some adjustments to these. And I'm not going to go through all the details of each adjustment, but this is just to give you an idea of the types of adjustments that can be made to get the adjusted amount. So for operating income, you'll see right here we have the adjustments. This is basically taking the operating income, making some adjustments, and then getting to what we need for the economic value added calculation. We'll start with operating income over here of $3,295,000, and then we're going to add back some research and development expenses that were deducted to get to that operating income, because remember, we want to capitalize those expenses for the purposes of the EVA calculation, meaning record them as assets rather than as expenses. So we're going to add back research and development expenses of $500,000. And then we're going to subtract the amount of those R&D costs that we want to amortize in the current period. So maybe we incurred costs, not maybe, we did incur costs of $500,000 for the year. We don't want to record all that as an expense. We want to only record one-fifth of that or $100,000 of that as an expense. And that calculation is different based on the company. So that just happens to be what was done here for this company. So we're going to add back the $500,000 in expenses that were expensed and then subtract the $100,000 of that $500,000 that we want to expense in this period. And then that gives us the adjusted operating income before taxes, and we'll simply subtract our income tax expense to get to the amount that we want to use for our EVA calculation. So that $2,586,000 then appears right down here for that division. That's the adjusted amount. And then we're going to make some adjustments to our average operating assets. That's this part down here to get to the adjusted average operating assets that we'll be using in the EVA calculation. So we'll start with our average operating assets of $29,350,000. And then we're going to add to that we're going to capitalize our research and development costs, the net amount of $400,000, that's the $500,000 cost that we incurred less the $100,000 that's expensed in the current period. So we're going to add the $400,000 to those average operating assets to increase them. And then we're going to subtract another adjustment here, our non-interest-bearing current liabilities. And that gets us to the average operating assets adjusted amount. And here it is, $26,350,000, and that appears right down here in the EVA calculation. And then we multiply to finish our economic value added calculation, now that we've adjusted our net operating profit after taxes and our average operating assets. We then take our average operating assets here, this $26,350, and multiply it by our cost of capital of 8%, and then we subtract that, which is $2,108,000, from our net operating profit after taxes of $2,586,000, and that gives us economic value added dollar amount of $478,000. And again, this is very useful, similar to residual income, for comparing divisions across periods. I should say staying within one division and comparing those numbers across periods. It's more useful for that than actually comparing divisions with each other, because it's just a dollar amount, it's not a percentage, and so it's very difficult to start to compare different divisions with each other. So it's really more useful for looking at a division over time. What are the weaknesses then of using economic value added? Well, EVA uses adjustments that depart from GAAP. So by doing that, we are no longer being objective. And some would argue that that's a poor direction to go, that if we're going to be subjective, we can start to manipulate the numbers, and it's not as useful once we start doing that. So we get away from the objectivity of using GAAP. And secondly, managers may have an incentive to use the inappropriate useful lives for R&D, and marketing expenditures, for example. Maybe we, instead of using 5 years for amortizing research and development, we'll push it out to 10 years, and that would then make me look better if I'm the manager of that division. So I guess what it really comes down to is that the numbers can be manipulated once we start departing from GAAP. We have to be very careful that we're trying to make this measure useful for us as a company and not use it to manipulate our results.